Hello dear, my name is Umar Farooq Mehboob Pasha Halli, lecturer in electrical department from Mahmood Dada Mani Institute. Today we are discussing a subject of electrical and electronics measurement under the program of electrical engineering with the semester of third. In that, today we are discussing a unit first. The unit first is fundamental of measurement. The fundamental of measurement, it has 10 months weightage. So today, before we start this session, I will introduce the today's content. The first content is that introduction of measurement. After that, classification of unit, classification of instrument, classification of standards, comparison between analog system and digital system, and calibration methods. These all points we are today are learning. So start this first point, introduction of measurement. What is mean by measurement? Actually, we know about the measurement, but in the form of technical language, the measurement system is nothing but the physical parameter or quantity is converting into a meaningful number. So that's called as a measurement. For example, speedometer, voltmeter, and ammeter. We are taking a basic example for the speedometer, because the in two-wheeler vehicle, when the vehicle is rotated with some speed, whatever the speed is displayed in the meter means that the vehicle rotation is nothing but the physical parameter or physical quantity. It will convert into a meaningful number. That means the whatever the speed is declared or shown by the meter, that's called as a meaningful number. This is simple definition of the measurement. The next is classification of unit. The units is the main part of the measurement, because every parameter has their own units and a different unit depend upon the parameter. That the basically they are divided into three sections, such as CGS, MKS, and SI. These three categories are main part of the units. What is mean by CGS? Centimeter, that is gram, G, and second. The long form of CGS is nothing but centimeter, gram, second. Next, MKS, meter, kilogram, second. Whatever the unit is considered in centimeter, gram, and second, the second is MKS, that will consist of meter, kilogram, second, and last final is, that is international system of unit. This parameter is further divided into three categories. First, base unit. Second, supplementary unit. Third, derived unit. There are three basic classification of that assignment. This called as a classes. So first class is base unit. In that, Electric current is found. After that, mass. After that, in example of that length, meter, and etc. If you are discussing electric current, it is measured in ampere. What's measured in ampere and denoted by capital A. After that, mass. Mass is measured in kilogram. And denoted by kg. Next, length, that is measured in meter, denoted by small m. This electric current, after that length, mass, that will be the parameter which undergoes to the base unit. Now we are discussing about supplementary unit. Supplementary unit is a related to the angles, such as a plane angle, solid angle. These two plane and solid angle include in a supplementary unit. The solid angle is measured in steradian. It is denoted by SR. And plane angle is measured in only radian, and it is denoted by RAD. Okay? Next, we are goes to the derived unit. Derived unit is, there is a number of parameters included. I will tell you some only few parameters, such as velocity, force, power, potential difference, and etc. We are discussing about the units. Then velocity is measured in meter per second, that is m oblique s denoted. So the force, we know that the free force is measured in the values that there is a tension and the pressure of that particular parameter, which is, for example, if you are discussing about the mechanical, there will be the tension process is there. If you are given an example of the engine, if you are including the engine in that fuel, they will be given some power, that's called as a force. After that, power is related to the electrical. Power is related to the electrical. Power is nothing but the voltage and current. So whatever the power is produced from the circuit, that's called as the power, and it is measured in watt. After that, potential difference. Actually, potential difference is nothing but the voltage. So it is measured in volt. Okay. Now we are discussing about classification of instrument. Now, next bit is classification of instrument. We are now discuss the introduction of measurement. After that unit, now we are discussing about the instrument. The instrument divided into mainly two categories. The instrument, that is, has two classifications. One is a secondary instrument, right? And second one is a absolute instrument. There are two classification of that instrument. In that, further, the secondary is divided into three categories. One is indicating instrument, right? First is indicating instrument. Second, recording instrument. Last one is integrating instrument. Basically, if you are discussing the classification of instrument, mainly has two parts. One is the secondary instrument and one has absolute instrument. But in that, secondary instrument has further divided into three categories: indicating, recording and integrating. Now we are discussing in the detail. First, we are discussing the indicating instrument. Actually, we are awareness about the indicating. The name is shows the indicating is nothing but showing. We have to take an analog meters. It has own parameters, that is a pointer and scales. If current is flowing in a circuit and we are connecting an ammeter, whatever the current in a circuit, it shows the reading of current. It means that it just showing is nothing but the indicating, right? This is a indicating instrument. Next, a recording instrument. Similarly, the name is indicate recording. It means that the storage. Recording instrument is nothing but whatever the reading of your circuit, that will be the recording with the continuous, right? If you take one example for that recording, in a substation there is a control panel. There will be the observation of all substation of a rating, such as a frequency, power, what is the input input voltage, output voltage, what is input power, output power, right? Current, voltage individual. These all parameter is recorded particular time. So that's called as a recording instrument. Okay. Next, the integrating instrument. There is a different name, integrating. Integrating is nothing but the event over a period of time. Means that, take an example for that particular integrating. Energy meter is the best example. Energy meter, you have to take whatever the reading of for 1 month, that 1 month of a reading include in the form of rupees. That means the period, that means the event over a period of time. That's called as an integrating instrument. Last, absolute instrument. What is meant by absolute instrument? Absolute is nothing but the whatever the parameter, physical parameter is, can be measured. Whatever the physical parameter can be measured in practically. How can I explain? Easily. How? If you are taking a circuit, make a circuit, for example, you have to take a supply, after that resistance, after that ammeter, and close your circuit. And give a supply, whatever the changes in resistance value, it means that the current will be changes. That means whatever the current is changes, that will shows the ammeter readings, right? That reading is practically shown. If you close your supply, that means the whatever the current in that circuit, the reading of an indicator or indicating instrument, it shows the zero value. It means that physical parameter can be measured in a practical. Okay, this is called as a classification of the instrument. Next, we are discussing about classification of standard. This is the main parameter which are discussing the standards, because everyone know has Then if you are discussing about the in India, there is a frequency of India is a 50 hertz. But you are compared to other countries, for example America, there is a different frequency, 60 hertz frequency. So it means that there is a own international standards ratings, right? For example, another in India, there is a rupees is considered, but in America, dollar. So that is this particular standardness is declared by the nation. So now we are discussing the standard. First, international standard. First is international standard. Second, primary standard. Third, secondary standard. And last one is working standard. This is a four factor which is included in a classification of standard. Now we are going to the international standard. What is mean by international standard? It is used in or it is can be used on the basis of international agreements. That is international agreements. That's called as international standard. Okay. Next, primary standard. This is also a standard on the basis of reference standard in laboratories, national laboratories in our in India, if you are discussing. So this is called as a primary standard. What is meant by secondary standard? This standard is based on the parameter which has undergo the industrial laboratories. What? Industrial laboratories. This is national and this is industrial. And last is the standard, working standard. What is meant by working standard? The standard whose given to the worker or technician who has worked in field. That's called as a working standard. For example, if you are taking a working standard, if input has 230 volt, this details is given to the technician or worker, so it will work on that 230 volt supply. This is called as a working standard. Okay. Now we are discussing about the analog system and digital system. Comparison between analog and digital system. The name is indicate the analog. Analog is nothing but it has a pointer and scales. But in digital is totally different. Digital has a numbering form. It has a numbering form. Okay, so I will take the comparison. Parameter analog system and this is digital system. So first parameter, if you are discussing about the cost, if you are discussing about the cost, analog is less compared to the digital. So digital is a high cost. Next, cost, after that reading speed. Obviously there is analog, there is a fluctuation is occurred in that reading if you are taking. So in that they are taking more time to show your exactly or accuracy of your reading. So less and this is fast. Okay, Next parameter, accuracy. Obviously, accuracy time is more taken in an analog system and digital less. After that, friction method or frictional we call as error, frictional error or frictional method. In frictional error, in analog we are taking a magnetic field, there is a friction between that magnetic field, so it has present the friction, but there is no parameter knowing in that digital, so there is no friction in a digital. Okay, next, the power required. What is the input power is required to the meter? Obviously, analog required high power. If you give the supply through the ammeter or voltmeter or wattmeter or frequency meter, whatever the meters, it requires supply and it requires 230 volt or 220 volt to 40 volts. It is a variation of voltage, it must be required to the ammeter, voltmeter and wattmeter. But in digital, there is no required supply because there is an inbuilt battery. So there is not required the high voltage or high supply. So it less supply is required for to run the meter. Okay, this is a comparison between the analog and digital. Okay. Next, calibration system. Next, we are discussing about the calibration. Now, what is meant by calibration? Why need the calibration? What is the process of calibration? Calibration is nothing but we are finding the error in any meters and we have to minimize this error with the help of standard meter. So we require the standard meter because standard meter has an accuracy of near about 99.7 accuracy output. But if you are using a normal ammeter and wattmeter or ammeter, voltmeter, it gives the accuracy near about 99.1 or 2. There will be the remaining part is a error or losses, but in that standard there is no losses. Okay, so we have to must use the standard meter. Okay, what is the procedure? So I take the example calibration of ammeter. Calibration of ammeter. ठीक है? This is DC supply. We are taking DC supply. After that resistance. This is standard meter and this is calibrate to be meter. Okay, this is R1, R2. This is DC supply. We are taking two resistance in a series. R1 is a fixed value, R2 is a variable value. After that, there are the two meters. This is a calibrated meter. We have to find out the error in that meter. This is calibrated and this is a standard meter. We are compared with this calibration meter. If there is a difference between both meter, that means your calibrated meter is faulty. You have to repair or you have to remove. Okay? If you start the supply, the current will start flow from R1, after that R2. But in that, R2 can be changed easily because the R2 is a variable resistance. So you have to change the value. That current will be indicated by these 2 meters, right? The standard meter and calibrated meter, the current of both meter is the same. It means that your calibration of system is okay, or there is a no fault in meter. There is no fault in meter. But if any difference between the values in 2 meters, that means your meter, that is calibrated meter, that is you are using a meter, that will be the fault. Normally, every domestic line, there will be the lot of people told us, sir, there will be the meter reading is showing wrong. So how can check this? It is easy process. You have to check by the help of standard meter. The standard meter is available in MSCB section. So we have to tell him, sir, you have to check whether my meter is right or wrong. So he will check with the standard meter. Okay. Similarly, this is also, this system also, standard meter and calibrated meter, you have to check the whether our meter is okay or wrong, or given is a correct value or accuracy value. So by help of standard meter, how can find out the error? By measured value minus true value divided by true value. That is, measured value is nothing but calibrated. True value is nothing but standard value. That means I2 minus I1 whole divided by I1 into 100. We can find out the easily error. If your value is lies between the minus 0.5% to plus 0.5%, if between that value there will be the your meter is correct accuracy, or it will be the okay meter. Okay. Similarly, we are discussing about the calibration of voltmeter. DC supply, I think we have to use. This is a potential divider, resistance or potential divider. We are taking voltage, voltmeter. This is standard meter, and this is calibrate to the meter. We know that if you are connecting ammeter, you have to must connect in a series, and if you are connecting a voltmeter, you have to must connect in a parallel with your any circuit. Okay, so this is a potential divider, this is a standard meter, and this one is a calibration. What are the reading is faulty or okay? You have to check by the standard meter. Similar process. Have to start the supply, change the value of resistance. What is the voltage occurred in both meter? Because in a parallel circuit, the voltage is same in that all elements. Similarly, whatever the voltage is occurred in that particular resistance across, if the standard meter shows 10 volt, then calibrated also meter 10 volt, it means that your calibrated meter is the correct. If the standard meter is shows the 8 volt and your calibrated meter is shows the 10 volt or 6 volt, it means that there is a difference between the value of standard and calibrated meter. It means that your voltmeter is a fault. Okay. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you so much.